Hello students, I hope you all are fine. In today's lecture, I will start a new topic that is about indeterminate forms. Now, first of all, we have to know that what are indeterminate forms, and then we will discuss the methods that we can use when the indeterminate form occurred. For example, while dealing with the limit questions, for example, when we take a limit x approaches to x naught on some function. Here we have a rational function, okay, but I will just writing it f of x. Then we get sometimes infinity by infinity form or 0 by 0 form, or it may happen that we get infinity minus infinity form or infinity times 0 form or negative infinity times 0. Means if it happens that when we apply the limit on some function or some rational function, we get one of these forms, then we will use our L'Hopital's rule. Now the theorem says that L'Hopital's rule, this is L'Hopital's rule first form, and this is very easy to apply. Now the theorem says that suppose that f of a and g of a is equal to 0. Here look at this. We are taking the limit x approaches to a f of x divided by g of x. You know that when we apply the limit, for example, this limit x approaches to a f of a divided by f of x divided by g of x, and when we put the limit here, then we will get f of a divided by g of a. And if both of these are zero, because we are supposing that these two are zero, then that means we will get 0 by 0 form. Then this is known as indeterminate form. And now this is the condition that first we have to check whether it is indeterminate form or not. The next step is that f derivative of a and g derivative of a exists. Now the next step is that we take the derivative of our functions at that particular point. Means here we have a, so we need to find the derivative at that particular point of both the functions, means the functions in the numerator or the function in the denominator, and we have to check whether these derivatives exist. And we also need to check that the function or the derivative of a function at a particular point a is not equal to 0, that is in the denominator. Because you know that if we get a g derivative of a equal to 0, then we get an infinite form and it would be impossible for us to solve this further. Okay. Now, then we will take the limit x approaches to a, and if it happen, that means first of all we will apply a in these two functions, and if we get 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity form, then we will take the derivative at that point and check whether it exists. And if it exists, then we apply the derivative at that particular point, and that is our required answer. Now let us look at a particular example, then it will be clear to you that what kind of situation occurs while solving the questions. For example, this is the question, and you know that if we take the limit x approaches to 0, basically this is our limit x approaches to 0 f of x divided by g of x. First of all, we will check whether it is 0 by 0 or not, means whether it is in indeterminate form or not. Now let us put 0 here, then I will get 3 times 0 minus sine of 0 is divided by 0, and you know that it is equal to 0 by 0 and it is in indeterminate form. It is in indeterminate form. So the next step is we take the derivative of numerator and also the denominator at this particular point. Means if we take the derivative, you know the derivative of a constant will be plugged out, and the derivative of x would be 1, means we will get 3, and the derivative of sine x is equal to cos x, and also the derivative of x is equal to 1, and we need to find this derivative at x is equal to 0. So I write it here. This is particular way to represent the derivative as some particular point. Okay, Now, when we substitute x here, then we will get 3 minus cos of 0 is divided by 1. And we know that cos of 0 is equal to 1. Okay, then we will get 3 minus 1 and that would be equal to 2. And this is our required answer. Now, in today's lecture, I have discussed about indeterminate forms, means what kind of situation occur, then we say that it is an indeterminate form. And we have discussed a theorem, means L'Hopital's rule first form. In the next lecture, I will discuss its stronger form, means L'Hopital's rule second form, or we sometimes say it's a stronger form. And we also discuss an example. And this is all about today's lecture. See you next time. Thank you.